to review, in Log Minute 6, we explored the first two major properties of logarithms, the product rule and the quotient rule. Looking back at those previous notes for Log Minute 6, recall that the product rule involves addition and the quotient rule involves subtraction. Our new Log Minute 7 explores the third major property of logarithms called the power rule. The power rule for logs comes from the definition of an exponent and from the product rule for logs. To expand, the log of u cubed is an example to demonstrate the power rule. Remember what u to the third means. U to the third means u times u times u. The log of u times u times u is the log of a product. So we can use the product rule for logs, which is log of x times y equals log x plus log y. So log of u times u times u equals log of u plus log of u plus log of u. Well, this is three log u's added together, which is 3 times log of u. Now, look back at this string. Look at where we started, log of u cubed, and look at where we ended up, 3 log of u. The power 3 ended up multiplied in front of the log. This is a specific example of the power rule for logs, which says that the log base a of x to the power p can be written with the power multiplied in front of the log, p times log base a of x. The power rule will be important when we solve log equations. If we have the log of 5 to the power x in an equation, rewriting it using the power rule as, putting the power in front, x times log of 5, will make the equation much easier to solve. In our first fill-in-the-blanks example, the log base 2 of y to the 5th is the log of something to an exponent or power. So the power rule for logs says that the exponent 5 can be multiplied in front of the log. Log base 2 of y to the 5th is the same as 5 times log base 2 of y. The second example uses the property in reverse. We have a number multiplied in front of a log. Using the power rule backward, the number in front can be written as a power. So the 2 can be written as a power on the t. Log base 8 of t squared. Now we need to put all three properties together in some mixed examples. We'll need to decide which rule applies, the product, the quotient, or power, and apply the rule. I'm going to copy all three log rules here so we can refer to them. The first column has the directions expand into a sum or difference of logarithms. Now, this does not mean the kind of expansion we did in our first introductory example, where we expanded u cubed into u times u times u. That's not the kind of expansion that they're referring to here. That introductory example was just an illustration of why the property rule works, but we won't need to do that anymore. So what this means is to use the properties in the forward direction, where this is expanding into a sum, this is expanding into a difference, and we'll also in this column use the power rule in the forward direction. Well, in the second column, we'll use the properties in reverse to write as a single log. Example 1, the log of 5x, that's the log of a product. 5x is a product, so we'll use the product rule. The product rule involves addition, so the log of 5x equals the log of 5 plus the log of x. Number 2, this is the log of a quotient. The quotient rule says take the log of the top and subtract the log of the bottom. So to expand log base 2 of 2y, 2y minus 5, that becomes the log of the top minus the log base 2 of y plus 2, the log of the bottom. Since there's minuses and pluses in the arguments, we need to keep the parentheses on the arguments to keep the log all together. Number 3 is the log of something raised to a power, so we use the power rule. Natural log of y to the 7th equals, bring the log in front and multiply 7 times natural log of y. For number 4, there is no radical rule for logs, but recall that we can write radicals in an alternate form, rational exponent form. The 4th root of t to the 3rd can be written in rational exponent form as t raised to a rational exponent or a fraction. The index becomes the denominator and the power becomes the numerator. So the 4th root of t to the 3rd can be written as t to the power 3 over 4. Index is the denominator. So log of 4th root of t to the 3rd is also log of t to the 3/4 in its alternate form. And rewriting it that way allows us to use the power rule for logs. Multiply the power in front, 3/4 in front, to get 3/4 times log of t. In the second column, we'll use these properties in reverse. Number 5 is two logs being subtracted. So which rule involves subtraction? That's the quotient rule that involves subtraction. So working in reverse, we combine the two log arguments into a quotient. So the quotient will be 28 over 4, which equals 7. So we have log base 7 of 7. Now the note says that we can evaluate this. So try it. To evaluate log base 7 of 7, we want to know what exponent goes on the base of 7 to get an answer of 7, since a log is an exponent. Well, 7 to the first power equals 7, so the log, or the exponent, is equal to 1. This is an example of one of the previous properties of logs, one of the simpler ones, that log base b of b is always equal to 1. Number 6 has a power, but also a number multiplied in front. It looks like the power rule. So if we use that power rule in the forward direction, we would multiply the power in front of the log, so we would multiply the 4 in front of the log, which then multiplies by the 3. So we multiply 4 times 3 to get 12 log of t. But actually we want the rule in reverse, so we want to take that number, the 12, and turn it into a power. So log of t to the 12th is the answer. Number 7 is two natural logs added together. So which rule involves addition? The product rule involves addition. So working it in reverse, we'll find the product of the arguments, y plus 2 times y minus 2. And that multiplies out to equal y squared minus 4. So the answer here will be the natural log of y squared minus 4. These problems are just exercises to practice using the properties of logarithms, but the real value of being able to use these properties will be using them to solve equations.